Japan backtracks on Iran oil embargo. The Japanese government on Friday began backtracking on its pledge to join Washington's drive to strangle Iranian oil exports, as top figures insisted no decision had yet been made. Just 24 hours after the country's finance minister indicated Tokyo was falling into line with U.S. demands, the premier and his foreign minister both signaled a significant retreat. The U.S. is trying to ramp up pressure on Iran over its nuclear program, threatening to cut off financial institutions that deal with the country's central bank, so squeezing Tehran's vital oil export business. And here's the key right here. Just like in Libya, the country's central bank. China has refused to play ball, but Washington appeared to score a diplomatic victory Thursday when Finance Minister Jun Azumi told visiting U.S. Secretary Timothy Geithner that Tokyo was planning to cut its imports from Iran. But on Friday, Foreign Minister Kochiro Gemba was less than enthusiastic. The United States would like to impose sanctions. We believe it is necessary to be extremely circumspect about this matter, Gemba told a news conference. We must look at this extremely carefully and find an intelligent solution. Well, that's something the U.S. can't do because they're bullies. We as a government are in the process of examining the issue and coming to a common position. Gemba said that over the last 5 years, Japan had reduced its dependence on Iranian crude, which now made up about a tenth of the country's oil imports. We are examining whether there is any advantage in a further reduction, but it is important to know what impact any reduction would have on the price of crude. And the U.S. doesn't care. They want a war. One can imagine there would be negative effects from the scheme, not just on Japan, but on the world economy. At a separate press conference, Prime Minister Yoshihiko Noda said his finance minister had been speaking in a personal capacity. Minister Azumi's comment was to recap what has happened in the past so far and expressed his personal views on the outlook, Noda told reporters. As a government, we wish to engage in more concrete discussions at a working level. Okay. Just typical. You know, somebody wants to do the right thing, and the U.S. is putting pressure on everyone to be a bully as well. And the Navy is depending on dolphins to keep the Strait of Hormuz open. If Iran closes the Strait of Hormuz, the U.S. Navy has a backup plan to save one-fifth of the world's daily oil trade. Send in the dolphins. The threat of Iran closing the strait has reached a fevered pitch, reports today's New York Times, with U.S. officials warning Iran's supreme leader that such moves would cross a red line, provoking a U.S. response. Iran could block the strait with any assortment of mines, armed speedboats, or anti-ship cruise missiles, but according to Michael Connell at the Center for Naval Analysis, the immediate issue for the U.S. military is to get the mines. To solve that problem, the Navy has a solution that isn't heavily advertised, but has a time-tested success rate: mine-detecting dolphins. I don't know why it is people, this tugs on people's heartstrings more than it does sending over their sons to these ridiculous wars. We've got dolphins, and they've had them for, I can't even tell you. I know in 1977, I was in Hawaii, and they were doing training in Hawaii. They now have training down in San Diego, and that's been ongoing probably since then. and they did release, I think it was six of their dolphins. Maybe they were getting too old. So they released them back into the wild. One was spotted up in Huntington Beach off the cliffs, frolicking with the surfers. And a personal friend of mine spotted a dolphin who towed a surfer just to see how far the dolphin would tow him, like a quarter of a mile down the beach till he let go. So yeah, this is pretty sad. They don't, you know, they don't care. So, Keating, they are astounding in their ability to detect underwater objects. Dolphins were sent to the Persian Gulf as part of the American invasion force in Iraq. I'd rather not talk about whether we use them or not. They were present in theater, so that means they did use them. Anyway, you know, dolphins possess sonar so keen they can discern a quarter from a dime when blindfolded and spot a 3-inch metal sphere from 370 feet away. They are invaluable minesweepers. So, sad as that is, that's just the way it is. Let's see, what else have we got? Iran sends a rare letter to U.S. over the killed scientists. Iran said on Saturday it had evidence Washington was behind the latest killing of one of its nuclear scientists. In the fifth attack of its kind in 2 years, a magnetic bomb was attached to the door of 32-year-old Mostafa Mahdi Roshan's car. His driver was also killed. U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Lyon Clinton denied responsibility. Of course she did. What is she going to say? Yeah? We have reliable documents and evidence that this terrorist act was planned, guided, and supported by the CIA. The Iranian Foreign Ministry said in a letter handed to the Swiss ambassador in Tehran, said TV reported, the Swiss embassy represents U.S. interests in a country where Washington has no diplomatic ties. The spokesman for Iran's Joint Armed Forces staff, our enemies, especially America, Britain, and the Zionist regime, Israel, have to be held responsible for their actions. Iran in the past has accused Israel of causing a series of spectacular and sometimes bloody mishaps to its nuclear program. Israeli officials do not comment on any involvement in those events, although some have publicly expressed satisfaction at the setbacks. So, the West says Iran's nuclear program is aimed at building a bomb. Tehran says it has the right to peaceful nuclear power. Well, yeah, actually, they have the right to arm themselves just like any other country. They have the right to defend themselves, actually. Anyway, just thought I would put that out there. Washington is requiring that countries gradually reduce their purchase. Well, the European Union is expected to unveil similar measures next week. Yeah, they don't care the global fallout from doing this. They want war. So, more as more arises. As always, God bless.